The raid of an Arundel gas station early this morning has led to the arrest of one of the town's selectmen. 63-year-old Byron Kinley is accused of running a fencing operation the York County Sheriff's Department says was used to buy up stolen property from recent burglaries. Kinley and his 46-year-old girlfriend, Tina Gagne, are also arrested and charged with trafficking. Authorities say the operation centered around the gas station Kinley owns in Arundel along Route 111, right on the Biddeford town line, and that's where we find News 8's Keith Baldi live tonight with more on this story. Keith.
Well, Jim, this gas station is a popular spot owned by a popular guy, an Arundel selectman, but police say this is where he was buying stolen property using money and drugs.
As the sun came up, investigators from the York County Sheriff's Department loaded all kinds of merchandise, big and small, into a parked van. $15,000 worth of stuff they say was stolen in a recent string of home burglaries throughout the county. Shortly afterward, they placed 63-year-old Arundel selectman Byron Kinley into a cruiser, charging him with drug trafficking and receiving stolen property. They also arrested Kinley's girlfriend, 46-year-old Tina Gagnon, on drug trafficking charges. All the charges stem from what authorities call a fencing operation, where thieves would bring the goods to Kinley's gas station in exchange for cash or Vicodin pills.
We believe that a lot of the items stolen and some of the other burglaries have already moved on. We have a pretty good idea where they went. We're following up on that, and we're also following up on other leads as it pertains to this case.
Leads concerning others involved and other burglaries. The sheriff says the crimes may have stretched all the way into New Hampshire. He would not elaborate, but did say two different suspects are already in custody, with more arrests likely on the way. But the sheriff says today's arrest of Kinley is a little more disconcerting, considering he's a selectman.
People that are put into that position and that are elected by their peers, people would like to think that they wouldn't have to be concerned with this allegation.
Allegations that Dana Peck, chair of the Arundel Board of Selectmen, says he never saw coming.
I think I know Byron pretty well, and it was really a surprise to think that he would be arrested for something like that.
But they're only allegations, says Peck, and that's why right now the board will take no disciplinary action.
We try to play by the rules for everybody, and it will be Byron's decision whether or not he resigns or if he shows up to the meetings for a period of time. I'm going to leave that up to him.
Now, the select board chair says if voters don't want Kinley in office, they can launch a recall effort, and if he is convicted, then the board may take action. We're live in Arundel. Keith Baldi, News 8.